Hi everyone, welcome to my channel Babs Projects, and today I'm going to show you how to make Sabudana Khichdi. And mind you, this is non-sticky Sabudana Khichdi, because one of the complaints that most of my friends have is that when they make Sabudana Khichdi, it always turns sticky and gooey, and that's not the texture you want. So I'm going to show you how to make the perfect non-sticky Sabudana, and the secret to that is how you soak Sabudana. Sabudana is actually tapioca pearls in English, but I'm going to use the word Sabudana so that it's easier to understand. So if you follow me, I'm going to show you how to soak Sabudana for the perfect outcome. So just follow me and I'll show you how to do it. So here you can see I have already washed and rinsed the Sabudana, and to this I'm going to add water, and I'm going to show you how much water to add. So I have a lollipop stick which I have marked with the food coloring, so I'm going to place that in the center, and you have to add water until up to that level. So you see this, I have added water up to that level, not even a little bit more, not less. And now I'm going to leave this, I will set it aside, and I'm going to allow it to soak all of the water for around 2 to 3 hours, and then I'm going to use the Sabudana. So I'm going to set this aside, and I already have a bowl of Sabudana which I had done earlier in the morning. And now if you see, if I press them between my fingers, see how easily they crush. So this is the texture you need. So to this Sabudana, now I'm going to add some coarse peanut powder. You can see how coarse they are. I don't want it fine. I want to have some texture, some bite to it. So I'm just going to add this. And I'm going to fluff this with a fork. You see how nicely it has soaked and swollen. That's what we want. I'm just going to eyeball and add some peanut powder to it. Mix them. The proper measurement of all the ingredients is up on my blog, and I will be posting the link to this post below. I would like to add some more. And that's it. This is done. I will set it aside, and I will get my other ingredients ready. So you can, when I come back, I can show you how to do the whole recipe. So now that I have all my Sabudana ready and prepped to go, I have also got some of the other ingredients. You can see the ingredients list is pretty simple and basic. You have some cumin, butter, salt, green chilies, potato, and turmeric. So if you follow me, I will show you how to start this recipe. So for this recipe, I take a non-stick pan. I like to use a non-stick pan because I don't want the Sabudana to stick to the pan. So non-stick pan works really good. And to this, I'm going to add butter and wait for it to melt. This is another one of my tip or secret, as you can see. I like using butter in my khichdi and not oil, because I feel like butter gives it a really nice and smooth flavor. So I like to use butter. Some people use oil, but I feel butter is best for this recipe. I'll wait for the butter to melt a little bit more. And to this, I'm going to add some cumin seeds. and then the green chili. I'll saute it for a couple of seconds. That's it, not much. And then I'm going to add the potatoes. Now if you see, I have sliced these potatoes thin because I want them to cook faster. And now these, once I saute them, once these potatoes are cooked, I'm going to add the sabzi. So these potatoes will take around 5 to 7 minutes to cook. So I'll allow that to cook and then wait to add sabudana later. So I'm going to check and see if my potatoes are done. Just try to cut it in the center with a spoon. And you can see it's done. It is not even 5 minutes, less than that. And I like how the potatoes are looking. So now to this, I'm going to add the prepped sabudana. Turmeric. And salt. Now you have to remember that this turmeric is actually optional. Usually sabudana khichdi is made as a fasting food by women and are usually eaten by women for religious purpose. So they don't like to add turmeric, but I like to add turmeric because it gives a nice aroma and flavor to the sabudana khichdi. So I'm going to mix this all together. And if you want more information about fasting food, I have all the information on my blog. You can click on the link below to check out. So the khichdi is nicely mixed. I'm going to place the lid over it. And I'm going to reduce the flame to low heat and allow it to cook for 5 minutes, and then I'm going to check and see if it is done. It's been 5 minutes and I'm going to check on the sabudana khichdi. As you can see, it's perfectly done, and this is exactly how the khichdi should look. You can see most of the balls have turned, the pearls, Saya tapioca pearls, have turned translucent, and that is what you want. This is the perfect texture that you need. I have been making sabudana khichdi for a very, very long time, and this recipe that I have is a fail-proof recipe. It has never turned into a disaster. The thing that you have to always remember is don't add any kind of liquid once you start cooking this khichdi. Some people like to use lemon juice, and you know, don't use that. That will make it more sticky. So here it is, the perfect khichdi, non-sticky yet translucent. And if you like this recipe, comment below or like or subscribe to my channel and let me know what do you think of this recipe. And if you've tried it, then let me know how it has turned out.